What if you call me and don't feel me near you? Will you still trust me? What if I tell you to let go of the very thing that you think you have to hold? Will you trust me? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if it costs my life? Yes, I'll trust you, Lord. What if I lose the very thing I love so dear? Yes. Somebody say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. Somebody say, yes. Come on, put your hands up and say, yes, I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I can hear Jesus singing. He says this.
I know that he really hates me when everything is going well. But can you still believe in me when your life's a living hell? And when all the things around.
Tonight, American officials are warning that extremist groups could spread this violence back here at home, and ABC's Martha Raddatz brings us the latest.
It has been a long day of unrest in the region.
This morning outside the U.S. Embassy in Yemen's capital of Sana'a, protesters smashing windows and climbing the walls to the compound. At around 4:30 a.m. East Coast time, Yemen's spokesperson in Washington tweeted in all caps, "Protesters have stormed the U.S. Embassy in Sana'a." The assault, only the latest of a growing number fueled by anger at an amateurish, low-budget film made in Los Angeles and promoted by the Quran-burning pastor Terry Jones of Florida.
Then there must be an action or consequence.
The film is clearly meant to denigrate the Muslim prophet Muhammad, depicting him as a child molester. For 3 days now, protests have been raging across the Arab world. It started on Tuesday, the anniversary of 9/11, when a group scaled the walls of the U.S. Embassy in Cairo, tore down the stars and stripes, and raised black flags reading, "There is no God but Allah." By Tuesday night, the violence was spreading and deepening. The American consulate in Benghazi, Libya, was in flames, and the ambassador and three other Americans dead after militants attacked with gunfire and rocket-propelled grenades. By Wednesday, the crowd outside the embassy in Cairo had grown larger and the mood ugly. The rhetoric now a world away from the heady days of the Arab Spring last year. Despite the death and utter devastation at the U.S. mission in Benghazi, the State Department insists there was a robust security presence.
We determined that the security at Benghazi was appropriate for what we knew.
Yet just the day before the attack, Al-Qaeda's leader urged Libyans to retaliate against Americans for the death of a Libyan-born militant killed by U.S. drones. And days prior to the attack, the State Department knew that the anti-Muslim movie that has caused outrage had been running on Egyptian television. Yet there were no warnings about it to other U.S. missions. That film is now the focal point of the anti-American sentiment roaring through the Middle East.
This video is disgusting and reprehensible. There is no justification, none at all, for responding to this video with violence.
The film's origins are still murky, but law enforcement says they've identified at least one man involved in its production, Nakula Basili Nakula, a Coptic Christian who lives in California. Today, media and police were gathered outside his suburban home, but he never appeared. Sources tell ABC News he has received threatening calls and is scared for his life. And U.S. embassies around the world remain on high alert.
A University of Texas has issued an alert to evacuate all buildings because of death threats. Officials are reporting a caller claims to have placed bombs all over the campus. Police say so far they haven't found anything, but they are asking everyone to get as far away from campus as possible, just as a precaution.
What if you call me and don't feel me near you? Will you still trust me? What if I tell you to let go of the very thing that you think you have to hold? Will you trust me?